I know I am, even though my grandmother was Jewish.
Yeah.
I mean, we are seeing the importance of the Old Testament. We're seeing this amazing covenant that our God has made with Abraham and with all of us.
Yeah.
And, you know, we have the Messiah, a statue of your Messiah right here. And on Grace Street, his name is Jesus.
Thank you. Amen. It absolutely, it's profound. Because it's the end times, one of the things is we know the Jewish people have to come to their Messiah. But it's not just one side. There's another side to it. If the Jewish people are coming to their Messiah, the church has to come back to its roots. And it all comes together for 2,000 years. I mean, if you look at the book of Acts, the power that was there. Well, you had Jew and Gentile together. They celebrated Passover in Messiah. It was all together in Israel. But for 2,000 years after that, it's been separated. I mean, the enemy knows there's power in that. So it was separated for 2,000. And so the church lost something. The Jewish people lost something. They lost Messiah. They lost the Spirit. The church lost its roots, lost all those things. Well, we are witnessing now the Jewish people come back to Israel, come back to the Messiah, its beginning, and it's not an accident that more and more churches, more and more believers are turning back to their Jewish roots. At the center of this faith is not Rome, it's Jerusalem.
Yeah.
That is our home. And so more and more churches are having Passover. It's absolutely part of the center. And Jew and Gentile have never been together. Christians have never been so connected to Israel since the book of Acts. Israel even knows that their best friends are Christians now, more than any other people on earth. That it's absolute. It's an end time phenomenon, and this is part
of it. Israel is literally surrounded by her enemies.
Yes.
Does that mean anything?
Yeah. It is, and Israel has always been surrounded, and the Jewish people have always been surrounded because the ultimate one behind all this is the enemy. Mm-hmm. The enemy hates Israel.
Yes.
The enemy knows that if they come back to Messiah, he's finished.
That's it.
And so it has to be. I mean, if you want to see, someone said, show me a sign that God exists. And that man answered, the Jew, in one thing. Well, that's true. But another sign that God exists is that the enemy exists. Mm-hmm. And the other sign is what has happened to the Jewish people. No people have been so attacked, furiously hated in generation to generation. It's not just one thing. It's not just Islam. It's the communist, the Nazis, everything for 2,000 years. People, nations where they don't even have Jews, hate Jews, So what is behind all this? How come the most evil people in the world, the most satanic people, have all hated Israel? Because the enemy is behind it. That's
right.
Why more than anything, Hitler, more than winning the war, he wanted to destroy the Jews. That's why Saddam Hussein, as he's dying, he speaks of Palestine. Their last words are against the Jews.
Oh my.
It's because it's the enemy. And these are only pawns. Because he knows, he knows that if they win, he loses. And if they say yes to Messiah, he loses. The game's over. The thing's over. So, but on the other hand, if we know there's an enemy, we know that there's a God and we're on the winning side. Because the other thing is, he's been trying to wipe out Israel for, almost about 4,000 years, and all these nations tried to do it. They've tried to do it. Israel has had no army for 2,000 years, no defense, nothing. They're the tiny little nothing, and yet Babylon has fallen, Egypt's fallen, Assyria's fallen, Rome has fallen, Hitler's fallen. They're all fallen, but the nation of Israel lives because the God of Israel is alive and well, and that's the sign.
And it's physically impossible for Israel to have survived
the last few
decades.
They should not. Listen, I should not be here. The Hittites, you go to New York City and you'll see Hittites on the walls of the museum. You'll see Babylonians in the. But you'll see Jewish people, they won't be on the walls, they're actually real walking through the museum. They're on television, they're comedians, they're doctors, they're lawyers, they're real. There's no way we should be with the Amorites and the Hittites, only because God said, if the sun disappears and the moon and the star disappear, then the nation of Israel will disappear. But as long as I keep that going, I'm keeping this going. That's the sign of God's hand, because there's no way on earth they should survive. For 2,000 years, they didn't know how to fight, they weren't allowed to fight, and yet they survived. They go back to Israel, and all of a sudden God makes them the best fighters in the world. People who don't know how to fight.
Right.
They didn't know how to farm. And that land of Israel, nobody could farm. You put the land that couldn't be farmed and the people who can't farm, put them together and the land blossoms.
Yes.
That's God.
Yes.
That's God.
And
that's
I
enough.
Have seen
yes.
it.
Yes.
Yeah.
The desert blossoms like the rose.
I shared once when you asked me about coming to the Lord and that I didn't know what I was doing. I was hit by that train, and I went up this mountain.
Hit by a train, by the way, to get saved.
Yeah, that explains some things. You know, I went to the top of a mountain. I kneeled down on this rock, and I gave my life to the Lord. I found out years later, somebody reveals to me that mountain is dedicated to Satan. There's witches on the top. And I said, well, I came to the Lord on this rock. So that rock is the altar. I said, wow. I went on there. And then I saw something on the mountain, and it said in like graffiti, no Jew shall enter these sacred grounds. And I said, what is that? I mean, is it Nazis? I mean, what is it? And I realized it was Satan. And Satan for 2,000 years had been saying to the Jewish people, you shall not come back to Messiah. You shall not come back. And I said, well, too late, because I'm back. You know, and we're coming back. Too late.
Too late.
We're coming back.
We are truly in the last days that a Jewish rabbi who has accepted Jesus Christ as his Messiah would be the one to sound the warning. That's so biblical. The Jews are going to preach in the last day. Can we call it preach?
Yeah. The Jewish people, and this is for everyone. We're all one in the Lord, and we're all Jewish in the spirit. You know, but the Lord called the Jewish people to proclaim the message of God. You know, they exist for that reason, to bless the Gentiles. Yeah. But the thing is, for 2,000 years, they haven't had that message after the book of Acts. You know, and they did. The first ones, just a few of them, changed the world. But for 2,000 years, you haven't had it. So what's happened is Jewish people then have other messages. Marxism happened through Karl Marx. He was the son of rabbis. Right. You know, you have other, you have all these different messages without that, because they were born for one message. The one message is the gospel of Messiah. So the age is waiting for when they come back, then the message will go forth. We were born to proclaim this. And without that, the Jewish people will still affect the world. They'll still be the most influential people in the world because God ordained that.
Yes.
But without Messiah, they can't redeem the world. Mm-hmm. With Messiah,